Okay, on this, we're going to talk about a 90-degree bend and laying it out on a piece of pipe. It's a piece of straight pipe. The way the measuring tape orientation is, the deduction, and what that does is move the mark ahead on a 90. The common deductions for hand bending, for half inch, we got a 5-inch deduction. With AmTech, we rarely deal with half inch unless we're doing some specialty control type work. Most of this is going to be referring to a 3/4 inch, which is a 6-inch deduction for a 90. Sometimes we're dealing with 1 inch, and it's an 8-inch deduction. And then for some larger conduit, EMT, we might be dealing with some 1.25 inches, and that'd be an 11-inch deduction. What does that mean when laying out a piece of pipe? If you take a tape measure and measure your distance from where you're starting to where the 90-degree bend needs to happen, you're going to deduct either the 6-inch for 3/4, the 8-inch for 1, or 8-inch for the 1-inch EMT. You're going to deduct that from your measurement. So if you're measuring, I've got a little identification showing the hook on a tape measure. So if you got a tape measure and you're measuring, and let's say that measurement needs to be, let's say, 60 inches. So what would happen, 60 inches is what you need. You're going to subtract for 3/4 inch, 6 inches. So that's going to leave you at 54 inches. So you'd place a mark referencing your tape measure at 54 inches. Some people will figure this out and just overhang this hook on their tape measure 6 inches past their measurement and then use the 60. As long as you come up with the same measurement and the same mark on the conduit at 60 inches, subtracting 6 at 54 or overhang at 60 inches, that's okay. Now, orientation of the hook on the tape measure and orientation of the hook on a bender. This is the front of the bender. It's got the hook. That's the front of the tape measure. I call it the hook. The orientation, when you do this measurement, right, it's very important. If your hook on your bender and your hook on your tape measure are in the same orientation, because if you turn this bender around, you're not going to come up with that 60-inch finished product. So straight through measurement, hook on the bender, hook on the tape measure, same orientation, deduct from your measurement, 6 inch for 3/4, 8 inch for 1 inch, 11 inch for 1.25 inches. Now, some of these benders may have a little bit difference, especially on the 1.25 inches. So always read your bender. The bender head will tell you what the deduction is. There's a different manufacturer that does something a little bit different than the 11 inch. So make sure you read it. It's right on the head of the bender. Always read that. But the orientation of the hook on both the bender and the tape measure, same orientation for a straight through bend. Remember to deduct that 6 inches for 3/4.